Today, I want to talk about Chromebooks. First of all, let me welcome everybody back to the channel. But I decided to make this video today because I am currently in the market for a new tablet and a laptop. Now I chose to pick up this little tablet here because my laptop I know for sure is going to probably be a MacBook Pro, and that hasn't been announced yet. Hopefully this week, we'll see. But I picked up the Lenovo Duet, which is a Chromebook that came out last March or May, but you could hardly find it anywhere. In fact, all the stores by me were sold out and I couldn't figure out why, until I was able to get my hands on one and test it out a little bit. Now, if you're unfamiliar with Chromebooks, essentially they are tablets slash laptops that are mainly geared towards using them in schools or for light duty work. Google does make their own versions of Chromebooks that are a little bit more powerful, that may be able to do some more graphic intensive things, like maybe photo editing or video editing, but the apps just aren't there to be able to do it. So I predominantly like Chromebooks, not for that reason, but rather for an everyday tablet. Now I've been using this HP Chromebook. I think it's the X2 that I got maybe 3 or 4 years ago. It still runs perfectly fine, still very fast, but it is a 15-inch tablet and it makes it very, very hard to fit it in my camera bag that I carry with me every day, to just be able to pull it out and use. So I wanted something a little bit smaller to be able to take with me and just use it for general purpose things like media consumption, or even earlier today, I even used it to create the thumbnail for this video. I wanted something small to be able to use like that. So long story long, I picked up the Lenovo Chromebook Duet. And so far, I really, really like it. In today's video, I kind of wanted to go over my thoughts on it and give you some impressions, being that it's late 2021, and see if you should still pick one up as well if you're in the market for a new tablet. All right, I'll cut right to the chase. One of the things that makes this tablet so good is it costs less than $300. In fact, this one that I'm currently using has 128 gigabytes of storage, only 4 gigs of RAM, and doesn't really have very many impressive specs. But for all that you get in that $300 price tag, to me, it still really makes it worth it. Now, if you've never used Chrome OS before, I really like it just because it is more tied to a profile. It's very lightweight. You can run it on almost anything. And it's very similar to, at least to me, to Android, which is my OS of choice when it comes to smartphones. So having that in the tablet space or in a laptop, I really, really do enjoy. But this one not only is a tablet, but it also comes with its own kickstand and it comes with a keyboard, which is really great because sometimes you have to do typing. I was writing a script earlier and I wrote it on this very tablet, which is good enough. It's not impressive. It's a smaller keyboard. The keys are a little bit mushy, but I didn't have any problems doing what I needed to get done using that keyboard. And like I mentioned earlier, overall, it's a smaller device. It's 10.1 inches on the screen, so just a little under 11 inches. And it's a 16:9 aspect ratio on the screen. So I think when they designed it with media consumption in mind, like Netflix or Disney Plus or anything, or YouTube, right? And I gotta say, having that really, really works out well. So that's another plus for this sub $300 tablet. Now I apologize, I've been calling this a tablet the whole time. To me, it feels more like a tablet with a detachable keyboard than an actual laptop. But let's go over some of the other pluses, some of the other things I enjoy about this. So it has top firing speakers on the left and right, which is really, really good for having balanced sound. Now, they're not the loudest speakers, but then again, I don't think they were intended to be. I was using my AirPods Pro with them, and whenever I'm watching something on it, works just fine. So if you're like me, I don't think that's something that you really have to be concerned about. It's relatively lightweight, so I don't mind holding it for extended periods of time, but having that kickstand and even sitting it on your lap means that it's not going to be very heavy as you hold it and use it. So I really like that feature as well. Now, something I'm still testing out that's actually really, really good for a product in this price range is the battery life. If you're taking a tablet with you, you don't always want to have to charge it every 5 to 6 hours. But this has really long battery life. In fact, they're toting somewhere between 11 and 12 hours. It's a great all-day tablet to be able to take with you and not have to worry about charging it every single day. I also mentioned at the outset that it's not the most powerful tablet, but it is good enough for what I'm using it for. It's good enough for, like I mentioned, watching Netflix, writing emails, going through certain social media apps and things of that nature. It can even handle a bunch of different tabs open in Chrome, which is pretty good. That's what most people use a tablet for. Now, I wouldn't try to do any video editing or anything like that on this, but if you're an everyday user, like for this use case, this is a pretty good tablet. So yeah, I'm excited about this. I think I'm gonna wind up keeping it. Even though it came out last year, it's still a really, really good Chromebook. It's still a good tablet. But if you're in the market for a smaller tablet that's a jack of all trades and a master of none for a lower price point, I think this is gonna be it. I think this is the sweet spot when it comes to a tablet for general use. So those are just some of my quick thoughts and impressions. Like I said, I haven't been using this for very long, but I'm gonna continue to use it. And if you're looking to pick one up, try to act fast because I don't think they're gonna be in stores for very much longer. But that's gonna do it for this video. As always, please like and subscribe. Hit that bell so you get notifications every time I go live with a new video. And everyone take care, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.